love Akron. Actually, Ohio. We're from Texas, and so it's a little strange to find kind of your niche. And everywhere we go, everyone's just very welcoming and excited about it, and we hope that continues. We've seen our best growth in Akron.
My dad plays the drums, and he's always played, and so I just kind of grew up around it just ever since I was a kid. It's just kind of part of my upbringing, always been part of my life.
My grandfather directed orchestras and choirs for like 50 years, and my dad did the same thing for 30 years. So naturally, I didn't want to have anything to do with it.
I've been playing drums since I was like 6. I went and bought a bass at a pawn shop and started playing bass, and kind of forgotten about drums since then.
I started playing music when I was, I guess it was before I was 5, because I started going up to pianos and like hitting notes and trying to like make melodies.
Short answer, we met in college.
So we kind of joined together as a conglomerate rock musical group.
I find the most inspiration probably from the relational aspect of humanity. Can you say it like that?
Everybody is oozing with ideas. We do everything internally, from, you know, media stuff to the audio stuff to the songwriting.
Yeah, I miss home. I'm married. I would like to be able to afford a split-second plane ticket for my wife to be able to come up and visit us.
I'm a full-time professional photographer, and so I do that, and then we also schedule touring and stuff. So I'm kind of bouncing back and forth. I work a lot from the road. I get to do two of my most favorite things in the world for living. So it's definitely an experience that I'm very thankful and very blessed by. It
really does take a certain level of dedication. It's a journey. It's not an overnight thing.
I think to continue just to get to make art that connects with people, and that we just get to go out and love on people and hang out and again learn and just speak truth into people's lives, encourage people. I think there's so much music out there that's just so tainted and sad, and it's a lot harder to do music that is positive and uplifting and still do it in a way that's fresh and energetic.
For whatever the reason, if the band ended and somebody said, "Hey Nick, come play with this other band and they're huge, go do that," I don't know if I would, because I think with the group of guys in Sleeperstar, all of them are such good guys, we're all at similar places in life, we're all, you know, best friends. All the difficulty and the uncertainty of being on the road is made just so much smaller when you get to be around guys like that.
Getting to write songs with these guys, no stone gets left unturned, especially on the lyric side of things.
The goal for me is to do God's will in my life. For all of us as a band, is to be humble enough to accept whatever God, difficulties, blessings, whatever in our way, to do that well and to be faithful through that.
I never thought in a million years that I'd be doing this for a job. It's unlike anything I've ever been a part of.